Hello everyone in Medical Scribe. I'm Karar Haider, student at Baghdad Medical College. In the previous videos, we completed the integumentary system and we explained its most important details, in which we talked firstly about the skin, then we moved toward the skin appendages. After that, we talked about the fasciae. While in the upcoming videos, the skeletal system will be our topic, and we will talk today an introduction about this system. The skeletal system defined as the system that make the body internal framework that will give our bodies their general shape. This system will form about 20% of the total weight of an adult human, and it will composed of two main components: the bones and the associated connective tissue, such as the cartilage, the joints, the tendons, and the ligaments. So this is the general definition of the skeletal system and its main components. And now, we will talk about each component and understand it in general, because in the upcoming videos, we will talk about them in details. So the first component we have is the bone. The bone considered as the main part of the skeletal system, which is in fact a hard structure that creates the body's framework, or the body's skeleton. So the bones will be considered as the main component of this skeleton. And keep in your mind that the adult human skeleton, male was or female, will be formed of about 206 bones attached to each other. So it is entirely correct to say that the male and the female have the same number of bones. But of course, there are many differences between these two skeletons in order to serve each one of them. For example, the skeleton of the male usually longer and has a high bone mass, in comparison to the female skeleton that tend to be smaller and less strong. Another example is that the skeleton of females will have a broader pelvis and will be different from that of males, in order to accommodate for a pregnancy and to facilitate the childbirth. Well, we should also know that these 206 bones will be arranged into two major divisions, the axial skeleton and the appendicular skeleton. So, the axial skeleton will run along the body's midline axis, and its main function is to protect the internal organs. And this axial skeleton is made up of 80 bones in the following ridges: the skull, the hyoid, the auditory ossicles, the ribs, the sternum, and the vertebral column. So this is regarding the axial skeleton. While the appendicular skeleton, its main function is to facilitate the body movement, and this type made up of 126 bones, which are in the following regions: the upper limbs, the lower limbs, the pelvic girdle, and the pectoral or the shoulder girdle. So this is regarding the appendicular skeleton, and by these two types we completed the first main component of the skeletal system, which is the bone. While the second main component is the associated connective tissue. These components involve the following structures: the cartilage, which is a smooth and flexible substance that covers the bone's tip. And these cartilages will be more flexible than the bone, but stiffer than the muscle. The second component is the joint. This structure will occur in the place when two bones meet together. While the third structure is the muscle tendon. This tendon is a band of tissue that connects the muscle end with the bone. And finally, we have the ligaments. These structures are bands of strong, dense, and fibrous connective tissue that hold the bones together, and they are the key in the joint's function. So that was almost everything, an introduction about the skeletal system. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.